Struggling, having a hard time physically, emotionally, dealing with the challenges of life, we would talk about it. And she said, we have to do something. And why don't we put on a concert of songs that would be uplifting, hopeful, and give everybody some relief through music. And we decided, well, let's go ahead and do it. So here we are, and here you are. Which was our goal. This next song, it's not a brand new song, but I've actually never played for anybody. It's hot off the press, it's still wet. about a month before we came up with this concert idea here, I was writing with a friend of mine who lives in Hendersonville, Tennessee, by the name of Michelle Canning. I wanted to write a song about hope. Little did I know that it was meant for today. It was meant to be shared with you. We didn't know it at the time. I'll play it for you. It's called The Light of Hope. And when I play it, I go finger picking it, going back to my folk days in high school. I used to listen to people, Paul and Mary and John Denver and all those people that did folk music back then. Like that, so give it kind of that style. So it's called The Light of Hope. Shine, shine, shine. going to do this next song here. It's a song that may be familiar to some of you. Very popular back in the 80s, I think. 1980s. just a beautiful song. This is a writer by the name of Dave Hanner wrote the song. But a really great country singer, John Williams, made it popular. And it's just one of the most beautiful lyrics I've ever heard in my life. And Heather is going to sing it for you, and we'll jump in on some harmony things here. But it's called "Lord, I Hope This Day Is Good." Songs pretty much, and this has got kind of a bluegrass beat to it, and that's how it goes in my world. It's called "I'm Gonna Sing My Cares Away." I'm gonna sing my cares away till they're gone like yesterday. Good times coming back to stay. Joyous sound. I'm gonna sing my yesterday. Good times coming back to stay.
Dreams. I was going to play the big stand-up acoustic bass, and I realized I had the smallest hands possible. It was never going to happen, so Dad kind of got me an electric, and I didn't really play it all that well, so we just stuck with singing. But this next song brings me back to the Allison Krauss days. I'm going to do Down in the Valley.
I went down in the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way.
songs with Heather, just like we did back when she was a kid. And this is a joy in my heart you could never put in words. That's all I can say.
And I guess speaking of hope, I would want to say anything is possible, because when I was in high school, I did theater, and then after that, I had no confidence. I was the shyest, quietest, introverted person, and I would never dream of performing. And it took until, and so my dad did 15 years, I think, of Christmas concerts, and it took until 2019 for me to say, I'll sing one song with you. And he said that, I was like, I've been waiting like 30 years for this. I was like, yes, and thankfully we did it, because then had we not, would have missed the opportunity, because then COVID came and that ended the Christmas concerts. But I got to sing with him my favorite Christmas song he wrote, which is called On Christmas Eve. I'm very grateful for that. So anything is possible, because I would have never dreamed I'd be here today doing this.
Here we are again. Any of you who know me know that my faith is a big part of my life. Faith in my family are the two most important things in my life. And because of that, because of my strong faith in my songwriting world, I write a lot of spiritual songs, a lot of gospel songs, bluegrass gospel songs, southern gospel songs, but songs with really important messages. And that's just how it turned out for me. And based on my teens and 20s, you wouldn't think I'd be doing that, but here I am. Just totally plugged into spreading the word of God through music and celebrating my faith. So this particular song is a gospel tune that I wrote with this woman who lives in Florida called Natalie's Shoemate. And I got to tell you a little bit about this. This song happened because of COVID. So when COVID hit, you know, churches had shut down and everybody was bricklayed to their homes and couldn't go anywhere. My wife and I still wanted to do something. So we started walking this trail near our house that goes out to Greenwood Lake. And we found the spot on the lake with sunrises, and you just stand there and the sun comes right into your face, right into your eyes. So we went there one Sunday, and we stood there and we prayed and we looked up in the sun and talked to God. And we said, that's what we can do. So we started going, like, not on Sundays, every day. We'd go every day of the week, and we'd go at the lake and we'd pray and talk to God. And that was the basis of writing this song, which is called Have You Talked to God Today? Have you talked with God today? Get down on your knees and pray. Thank you. When the night has come,
50 per day. It's kind of a self-thought, you know, requirement of at least one good deed daily. And without expectation or without concern, I am a firm believer in best case scenario. And I know that that is not, many people don't shift that direction. We do have worries and such, but I may have disturbed my mother a year ago at Christmas when I said, I picked up a hitchhiker down to Exeter. She said, you did what? I said, well, the man, it was cold outside and he needed a ride and he was going here, and why would you do that? You know, concerned, but I'm like, it's best case scenario, you know, unless otherwise, you know, felt, but I'm a firm believer in truly that will push you forward in that being the case instead of, you gotta prepare for this. Well, we spend a lot of energy on preparing for what doesn't happen. Or, you know, the fears and the worries take up so much energy, and most of the time they're not fulfilled. So let's all try to embrace the best case scenario and one good deed.
And when I wrote this song with a friend of mine, Daryl Mosley, who's one of the most talented singer-songwriters in Nashville, and when I presented the idea to him, I was thinking back when I was a kid. I was a Cub Scout and then a Boy Scout. Is anybody here ever involved in scouting or had kids who were in scouting? I still love the scout motto to this day. I can't remember what I did yesterday, but I remember the scout motto. Word for word. So I was thinking back, what do we taught in scouts? A lot of the things that I learned stuck with me for life. I learned a lot of core values and good behavior. And one of the things was, you're supposed to do at least one good deed every day. Open the door for somebody to do something. So I was just a little kid. Out there opening the post office door for somebody and doing that, and then 60 years later I'm doing the same thing, and I just feel like it was just part of the life process. It's just a good thing to do kind deeds. So I kind of made that the center focus of this song called One Good Deed Leads to Another. And musically we're going to make it a little bluesy and a little edgy in some of the other songs.
I'm going to read to you. It's by familiar. This is my wish for you. This is my wish for you. Comfort on difficult days. Smiles when sadness intrudes. Rainbows to follow the clouds. Laughter to kiss your lips. Sunsets to warm your heart. Hugs when spirits sag. Beauty for your eyes to see. Friendships to brighten your being. Faith so that you can believe. Confidence for when you doubt. Courage to know yourself. Patience to accept the truth. And love to complete your life.
Next song we're going to do here. I didn't write it, but I wish I had written it. It goes back to, I have trouble putting this tape on, right? If it's not right, it just does not sound good. You would notice that. That's better. So there's these two kind of Americana country performers back in the 80s called the O'Kanes, was their name. And the duo, Kerry and Kane and Jimmy O'Hara. And they're really good, and I love them. There was one song on one of their records just floored me. And I'm going to do it for you. It's just one of the most beautiful, simple songs I've ever heard in my life. Never so beautiful. Amy Lou Harris recorded it one time just because she had to do it. It's called When We're Gone, Long Gone. had to sing, I had to include the song here today. The song of a dear friend of mine whose name is Troy Engel. He lives out in Pennsylvania, and we write a whole bunch together. And, remotely, of course. We have a long drive out to his place and my place every day. Just to write for 2 hours and drive home, that'd be tough. But we've written some of the most meaningful songs I've ever written. I've written with Troy. And when we get together to write the song, we're thinking back on our lives. Like, he's not quite as old as me, but he's not really young either, so he's kind of at an in-between stage here, I guess. And we're thinking about our lives and regrets that we have, maybe misuse of our time, missing out on an opportunity, things that if we had to do it over again, we'd do over again. And when we get all done, the song was about making every minute count in your life. So we said we got to write a song about making every moment in your life count. So that's what the song is all about. And I'll do it for you.
I will learn these songs. songs. I don't know them, but I will learn them. And I also want to thank my mother, Wendy Lang, for letting us take the last 4 months to prepare for this, because she's been spending a lot of studio time and extra time preparing for that. So thank you for kindness and grace through all of this. Into Three Little Birds and have bookends, and anybody that wants to join in on that, please feel free to.
Need